cybersecurity is an issue that only continues to grow in importance for the industry. And that means ICI is working globally on behalf of its members to ensure they have the resources they need to support their efforts. At ICI's recent Cybersecurity Forum, Peter Salmon gave me an update on our work.
So we continue to meet with our chief information security officers here on a periodic basis, but we've expanded that model in London and in Tokyo. And together working with other trade associations, we've gotten together with investment management companies and their security professionals and impressed upon them the importance of creating a network, a community of peers that is trusted, where they can come together and share information, especially in Asia and Japan and Australia. So those are relatively new areas for us in forming these groups. There seems to be a lot of receptivity to that and forming connections with law enforcement, not only within the investment management community.
And in major operational centers like either Luxembourg or in Ireland, you've been engaged more there as well.
We had a very big event in Ireland together with the Irish Funds Association. A couple of hundred professionals showed up and listened to a panel of local law enforcement, FBI, and ourselves and a consultant talk about the security concerns that they should be paying attention to. So I think what comes out of it is a heightened awareness to the threat that everyone is facing. We're all in this together as well. This is a neighborhood problem. It's not an individual firm issue. And we're much stronger together as a group confronting this, sharing information, and approaching this with solidarity.
Then I guess you could maybe also almost call this the Neighborhood Watch Report. You also have a survey that you do around this time of year with members. Tell us where that activity stands.
This is the third year that we've done a very comprehensive cybersecurity benchmarking survey. We do one in the United States, and then we do one through an affiliate group of IOSCO globally, so outside the United States. And it's over 100 questions long, covers all sorts of different aspects of an information security program, and it has developed into a very valuable tool for these firms to use for having conversations internally between compliance and risk and IT, but also with the boards to demonstrate where their firm's program is and how their practices line up with industry practice.
So tell me about, from today's conference, some of the things you heard that you think are the most significant for the industry to think about, keep an eye on.
Well, I think there's a lot. I mean, one was cloud computing, and that's a wave that's pretty much already here, but continues to build and take over how our firms look at where they put their infrastructure, where they put their services, and what platforms they use. And data loss prevention was another panel. Obviously, a big concern about exfiltration of data and the steps to take to manage that. And creating a security environment within a firm, a trusted but monitored environment. Unfortunately, I suppose this is an area that continues to evolve and get more complex as technology gets more complex. So we're going to continue to have innumerable areas that we can discuss and share information with, as you said, non-technical individuals, give them concrete pieces of information they can bring back to their shop and explore further.